What's up internet, welcome back once again. I am Manish from rebellionrider.com. As in the introduction to exception handling, which was the last tutorial, we discussed that there are three ways of declaring user defined exception in Oracle database. In today's PL SQL tutorial, we are going to explore the first way and learn how to declare user defined exception using a variable of exception data type. So guys, without wasting your time, let's get started. The process of declaring user defined exception is divided into three parts, and these three parts are: first, declare a variable of exception data type. This variable is going to take all the burden on its shoulders. Then, raise the exception. This is the part where you tell the compiler about the condition which will trigger the exception. And then comes the last part, which is handle the exception. This is the section where you specify what will happen when the error which you raised will trigger. So let's write the code demonstrating all the above steps one by one. Like always, I will try to keep the code as simple as possible so that you guys can understand the concept clearly. Let's do it then. Here we have the declaration section of the anonymous block which we are writing for today's demonstration. In this declaration section, we have four variables. Among these four variables, first three are normal number data type variables, and the fourth one, which is ex_div0, is the special exception data type variable. This variable will become our user defined exception for this program. Now let's move on and write the execution section of this anonymous block. Before moving ahead, let's take a quick break and look at what we just did. Here I raised an error using the raise condition. In order to raise the error, we use the raise statement in which we first write the keyword raise followed by the variable of exception data type, which is ex_div0 in our case. Raise statement changes the normal flow of execution of the code. As soon as compiler comes across a raise condition, it transfers the control over to the exception handler. In order to avoid these unwanted switches during the control flow of the program, we use the if condition. Using if condition, we are making sure that this error will come into action only when the divisor is equal to 0. Now let's move ahead and write the next segment of this section. Here is our next segment where we are performing the arithmetic of division operation and storing the result into the variable var_result, as well as displaying back the output using the dbmsOutput statement. It's pretty simple. Next, we will write the exception handler for the variable ex_div0. Here we have the exception handler for the variable ex_div0. In this exception handling section, we have a dbmsOutput statement which will get displayed when our user defined error, which is ex_div0, occurs. Now before executing this program, let's take a quick overview of it. In this program, we declare a variable of exception data type and named it ex_div0. This variable is working as a user defined exception for our anonymous block. This PL SQL user defined exception will come into action only when the divisor is equal to 0. If the divisor is 0, as it is in our case, the error will be raised and then the control of the program will escape all the following statements and look for the matching exception handler. If it finds any, then it will perform the action accordingly. Otherwise, it will either terminate the program or prompt you with a system defined error for unhandled user defined error. For more detailed information, you can visit my blog on the same topic. Link is in the description. For now, let's execute this PL SQL block and see what happens. So here is the output, which is the string from the exception handler. This string is here because our divisor is 0. Let's change the value of our divisor and then try executing this program once again. Let's execute the code once again. This time, we have the actual value as result, which shows there is no error and the program control has executed all the statements. That is how we declare user-defined exception using a variable of exception data type. Hope this example helped you with the concept and you learned something new. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and do make sure to share this PL SQL tutorial on your social media as it will help others in learning as well as me and my channel. That is the tutorial on how to declare user-defined exception using a variable of exception data type. Thanks for watching. I will be back soon with the next tutorial. Stay tuned. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.